Sometimes Whitney, if she did it 2 or 3 times and she knew they were good, she's like, okay, am I done? My name is Mervyn Warren, and I am the producer and arranger of the soundtrack to the film The Preacher's Wife, starring Whitney Houston. I had produced other artists. I had written arrangements for other artists. And so I guess I had a reputation already as a producer. When Whitney signed on to do The Preacher's Wife and heard about the team that they were forming, she asked for me. I will say that that did blow my mind. Even though I knew her, I had not officially worked with her in the studio, but apparently she knew enough about me as a producer that she did ask for me. I will always let you win. People heard that she was doing this, that people were submitting songs, like new songs that they had written, but the script didn't call for that as much. Penny wanted to use, but we did not use a lot of those new songs that were submitted by people. Whitney could sing The Phone Book, you know, everybody has said that she could sing anything. So I wasn't worried about that. I just wanted to make the arrangements worthy of her voice. And I knew this was a big deal, so I wanted to make those arrangements interesting. Had another objective, which is to serve the film. I couldn't just go willy-nilly and just do anything that I want, because in the story, a certain song might need to be simple because maybe they're rehearsing and they're not ready yet. And of course, Whitney, whether it was piano or full orchestra, that voice on top of my tracks was just something that I will always be proud of. And I can't be prouder of the work that we did together. I remember when we were filming the scene where Whitney sings Who Would Imagine a King, the script called for this song that would be sung during the nativity. I remember playing that for Penny at her house, and she loved it, and she played it. She must have played it 3 or 4 times. And when we filmed the scene where Whitney is with the kids on the stage and the little girl runs off and Whitney has to finish the song, it just so happened that Denzel was there. I will never forget when Whitney started singing Who Would Imagine a King, I looked over and Denzel was crying. That just says so much. For me, it was like, oh my God, I wrote this song. Oh my God, Whitney is singing a song that I wrote. And oh my God, it made Denzel cry. That's a moment I'll never forget.
Well, there's a bridge and there's a river.
Whitney was a lot of fun to work with. We just laughed a lot. We laughed between takes, we laughed. And you know, look, she was human. And sometimes if she was singing, if she did something she didn't like, she'd like, no, we're doing that again. I'd be like, okay. She didn't take herself too seriously. There was always levity.
Where do I go?
The Preacher's Wife is unique because it featured Whitney. I believe everyone would agree that Whitney was a special talent. I am so honored that Whitney chose me to produce her songs for this movie. I know that it was sort of a dream of hers to do a gospel project because she grew up singing gospel music, and this movie became that vehicle for her to do this. She just brought something so unique to every performance, and it's something that you just never forget, whether you're just hearing her live on stage or seeing her do it in the studio. I'll cherish those memories.